गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर 17 वी विल डिस्कस द एनर्जी बैंड डायग्राम ऑफ पी एन जंक्शन एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट वी विल डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ बैरियर एनर्जी ई बी और द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर पोटेंशियल बैरियर वी बी इन दिस एनर्जी बैंड डायग्राम ऑफ पी एन जंक्शन. So first of all, draw the energy band diagram of PN junction. So in this energy band diagram, we have a semiconductor whose one side is P-type, other side is N-type, and there is PN junction, the boundary which divides this P-side and N-side of a semiconductor. And this region, we all know that this is depletion region or space charge region. And when just after the formation of PN junction, the conduction and valence band on the P side, they raise themselves as compared to the conduction and valence band on the N side and creating the potential difference of VB, that is known as potential barrier, and barrier energy of EB between the conduction band on the both sides. And as we know that this is the Fermi level, this was the Fermi level in case of PN junction, and this red line, it is the Fermi level in the case of intrinsic semiconductor. This is the Fermi level in case of intrinsic semiconductor. But when this intrinsic semiconductor, it has changed from intrinsic to this P-type semiconductor, at that time this Fermi level, it will move from its central position to close to the valence band, top of the valence band. So suppose it has changed and it has shifted through energy EP, and this is the new position of this Fermi level in case of P-type semiconductor. This was the position of Fermi level, which is the middle of the valence and the conduction band, that is in the case of intrinsic semiconductor. In the same way, this red line, it represents the position of the Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductor, that is in the center of this conduction and valence band. But when this intrinsic semiconductor, it has changed from intrinsic to N-type, then this Fermi level, it will move towards close to the bottom of the conduction band. That's why it has moved or shifted upward close to the bottom of the conduction band, and energy shift, that is equal to En. This was the initial position, this is the current position. So the shift in the energy of Fermi level, suppose on N side is En, and on P side is EP. And the energy gap between the valence band and conduction band, it is given as EG. And in intrinsic semiconductor, as this Fermi level, it lies in the middle of the conduction and valence band. Therefore, this Fermi level, it divides the whole energy gap between this valence band and conduction band into two halves, EG by 2, EG by 2, in case of intrinsic semiconductor. In the same way, on this side, this initial position of Fermi level, it divides the total energy gap EG into two equal halves, EG by 2, EG by 2. Then, this I have already told you, that in N-type semiconductor, Fermi level shifts towards the conduction band. In P-type semiconductor, the Fermi level shifts towards the valence band from the center of the forbidden gap. And when the P-N junction is formed, then to maintain the Fermi level EF in a line throughout the whole semiconductor, the bands of P region, they raise themselves in energy than the bands of N region, conduction bands as well as valence bands. Accordingly, the Fermi level, it will shift from intrinsic condition to end-end p-type region. And suppose the shift in the Fermi level when it has changed from intrinsic to p region, that is EP, and the shift in the Fermi level when it has changed from intrinsic to n-type, suppose that is EN. So what will be the total change in the total shift in the energy level in the Fermi level? That will be EP plus EN. EP is the shift when intrinsic changed from intrinsic to P, and this is the change, energy change takes place when semiconductor changes its configuration from intrinsic to N. So what will be the total change in PN junction? So change in P, change in energy on P side and change in energy on N side. So it will be EP plus EN, and it will give rise to barrier energy, that is EB. And we have to calculate this EB. It means to calculate this EB, we have to derive the expression for this barrier energy. We need to calculate the expression of this EP and EN. So for this EP and EN, see the figure and calculate the expression of EP from there. So here we have, from the figure, EF minus EVP. What is this EF minus EVP? This difference. This EF minus EVP, this energy difference, it is equal to this EF minus EVP. So EF minus EVP, this total value, it is equal to EG by 2. This to this is equal to EG by 2. We have to calculate this. This is EG by 2. This is EP, and we have to calculate this. So this energy difference, it will be equal to EG by 2 minus EP. And what is this energy difference? It is EF minus EVP. So EF minus EVP, that is this energy, it is equal to EG by 2 minus EP. So we have this. And from this, calculate the value of EP. Move this to this side and both of these to this side, and you will get this equation 2. Now we have to calculate the expression for EN. For the expression of EN, we need the expression of EN for this. This whole energy is EG by 2. This EG by 2 minus EN, it will be equal to this energy. This is EG by 2. EG by 2 minus EN, it is equal to this. And this, what is this? This is ECN minus EF. So ECN minus EF, that is this energy, it is equal to EG by 2 minus EN. So you can see ECN minus EF. ECN minus EF, this energy, it is equal to EG by 2 minus EN. Now calculate the expression for EN, which is our equation number 3. Now put both the values of EP and EN in this equation number 1, and we will get the value for barrier energy. So barrier energy, it is equal to this, that is equation number 4. Now we have to calculate the value of this energy gap. We have to simplify the value of this energy gap. So we have derived in the previous lectures that concentration of electrons Ne and the concentration of holes NH, their product is equal to Ni square. Ne into NH, that is equal to Ni square, and it is equal to Nc, concentration of charge carriers in the conduction band, into Nv, concentration of charge carriers in the valence band, e raised to power minus Eg by kT, where k is the Boltzmann constant, Eg is the energy gap, T is the temperature. And how we will calculate the value of Eg, energy gap? Move this to this side and this Ni square to this side. And then move this to the numerator, the power will become positive. And we have to calculate the expression for this Eg. For that, take natural log on both sides. And we know that natural log of E is 1. So we have Eg by kT. And on right side, we have natural log NcNv by Ni square. And move this kT to this side. And now we have the expression for Eg. So, energy gap Eg, it comes out to be kT natural log NcNv by Ni square. And we will put this value in this equation number 4th here. But before that, we have to calculate the value of this. Energy of conduction band on N side minus energy of valence band on P side. So we have to calculate the values of these two. Then we will put all these three values in this equation 4th. So for that, in the previous chapter, we have already derived this expression. This was the expression that we have derived in the article of position of Fermi level in n-type semiconductor. And this expression we have derived in the article position of Fermi level in p-type semiconductor. So there we have derived these two expressions. We have to calculate ECN minus EVP. For that, add these two equations 7th and 8th. When you will add these two equations, this minus EF and plus EF, it will be cancelled out. And we have this on the left hand side. And this KT, it will be common. This natural log of M plus natural log of N. Use the formula natural log M into N. So, we will have this expression number 9th. Now, put the values of this EG and this ECN minus EVP in equation 4th, that is this equation. Put the value of Eg and this in this equation from equation 6th and 9th. So what we will get? Barrier energy, it is equal to this. From here, this kT is common. Then we will have natural log M minus natural log N. So, it will be equal to natural log M by N. This NcNv, it will be cancelled out. And we have barrier energy is equal to kT natural log of NaND by Ni square. And you have to learn this expression in case of numericals. So, this is the required expression of barrier energy in case of PN junction or PN junction diode. So, what will be the expression for potential barrier? We know that this barrier energy EB, it is equal to EVB. So, VB will be equal to, potential barrier will be equal to KT by E, natural log NAND by Ni square. So, this is the required expression for the potential barrier in case of PN junction diode.